I think this is all thanks to COVID-19 that we are all enjoying this very prestigious, very informative Technology Day celebrations, sitting at home or in our offices. And I don't think that ever in the past we could have witnessed participation of thousands of our own scientists in this Technology Day function in such a cool manner. So this is, I think, the new blessing of COVID-19, and all these good ideas and all these good practices that we have been forced to adopt during COVID times. I understand that in future times, if we continue to practice some of them, COVID will always be remembered as a blessing in disguise for this whole world. In this August gathering, where we have all come together to celebrate the 22nd National Technology Day, which has been organized by my ministry along with the active support of the Confederation of Indian Industry. The National Technology Day, we know, is observed on the 11th of May to commemorate achievements of innovations and technological excellence in the country. The day has a historic perspective, as it was on this day that India achieved a major technological breakthrough by successfully carrying out nuclear tests at Pokhran. And I would love to place on record my most humble tributes to the memory of two great leaders of India, my very dear Atalji, our former Prime Minister, and our esteemed President Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam on this particular day. Further, I remember that the first indigenous aircraft Hansa 3 was test flown at Bangalore on this particular day, and India also has performed successful test firing of the Trishul missile on the same day. Since then, that was 1999, the day is celebrated as the National Technology Day. We did that Pokhran in 1998, and next year we started celebrating the National Technology Day. The celebration of National Technology Day symbolizes India's quest for scientific inquiry, technological creativity and innovations, and the integration of these developments into national socio-economic benefits and global presence. We are interacting today amidst the most trying times globally as the pandemic COVID-19 marches on to destroy our lives and disrupt our economy. Apart from putting the healthcare system of various countries out of gear, the COVID-19 pandemic has also severely impacted the health of the global economy. The technological and other issues involved in the pandemic are both nuanced and complex. However, in the present crisis, technology has emerged as a forefront of the battle against COVID-19. As we all navigate through the unprecedented crisis, India's fight against the COVID-19 is moving ahead with great strength and steadfastness. Government of India has very effectively managed and contained the pandemic so far and done exceedingly well in mitigating the impact. Under the leadership of our Honorable Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi ji, India is taking positive strides in containing and managing this crisis. The Honorable Prime Minister has made a clarion call to utilize this challenging time not as a national crisis, but as an opportunity for economic revival, to promote Make in India initiatives and become self-reliant. In this regard, the Government of India is fully committed to facilitating Indian health and scientific community in the fight against COVID-19 with support from institutions like DST, DBT, CSIR, MOES, and the Technology Development Board. When it comes to science and technology, India as a nation has always risen to meet any challenge. As always in the past, we have taken actions with speed and scale at several fronts, which included comprehensive mapping of our entire startup ecosystem to identify and support relevant technology solutions ready for the scale-up, supporting industries and projects from academia and R&D labs working on modeling properties of the virus and its impact and novel solutions, activation of relevant DSTs, autonomous institutions in providing the solutions. The S&T response to epidemics like COVID in our country reflects the collaborative spirit of the entire ecosystem. Indian government, academia, and the industry is working to find solutions to combat this pandemic. Not just nationally, even international scientific collaborations have further intensified in this period and are taking place at a pace never seen before. This epidemic has also established that we need to further intensify our cooperation and build a sound bilateral relationship. Countries such as ours need to combine forces to seek sustainable answers to pressing unforeseen crises like COVID. The Government of India has set up a COVID-19 task force for mapping the COVID-19 related technology capabilities in startups, academia, research and development labs and industry. The capacity mapping group consists of representatives from DST, Department of Biotechnology, Indian Council of Medical Research, Ministry of Electronics and Information and Technology, Council for Scientific and Industrial Research, Atal Innovation Mission, Ministry of Micro, Small and Medium Enterprises, Startup India, and the All India Council for Technical Education. This task force has identified over 500 entities in the areas of diagnostics, drugs, ventilators, protection gear, disinfecting systems, etc. The solutions identified include masks and other protective gear, sanitizers, affordable kits for screening, ventilators and oxygenators, data analytics for tracking, monitoring and controlling the spread of outbreak through artificial intelligence and IoT-based solutions. We must acknowledge with great reverence that our scientists, our entrepreneurs, and our institutions have left no stone unturned while dedicating themselves in finding quick and deployable solutions for COVID-19. All the facets of developing new technologies such as scientific development and validations, industry partnerships for technology transfer, and scaling up of manufacturing have been adopted. Within a short period of time, India has been able to mobilize thousands of researchers in the country to work round the clock to develop new testing kits, protective equipment, and respiratory devices, etc. Our government has vigorously activated the Make in India program and involved various R&D institutions of the country in manufacturing the COVID-19 testing kits मास्क, अल्कोहल बेस्ड सैनिटाइजर्स, पर्सनल प्रोटेक्टिव इक्विपमेंट्स, ड्रेस मटेरियल्स फॉर फ्रंटलाइन हेल्थ वर्कर्स, वेंटिलेटर्स, ब्रीदिंग डिवाइसेस फॉर द पेशेंट्स. आई एम देयरफॉर एक्सट्रीमली हैप्पी दैट द थीम चोजन फॉर दिस ईयर्स टेक्नोलॉजी डे इज रीस्टार्ट, रीबूट द इकोनॉमी थ्रू साइंस, टेक्नोलॉजी एंड रिसर्च ट्रांसलेशंस. यस, we indeed need to mitigate the widespread economic impact and prepare for a stronger recovery using self-reliance as the new mantra and looking for new opportunities to galvanize the growth in technological and industrial sector. We are rightly poised for it. A large number of solutions for the current crisis have been provided by the young entrepreneurs. Be it the solutions in diagnostic kits, cost-effective masks with innovations in design, material and production techniques, automated disinfection robots using full depth disinfection cycle technology, thermal scanner with high quality thermal imaging, screening system with high resolution temperature range for mass scale screening provision, or employing computing techniques and artificial intelligence. Indian startups are at the heart of the solutions. We are a country that's full of optimism and energy. We have the intent and the young workforce that's required for the ultimate push towards a better tomorrow. Against this backdrop of the daunting challenges faced by the humanity, Technology Day this year assumes all the more importance as the scientists and technology leaders of our country have geared up for the national efforts while championing the best scientific and technological advances to attain technology leadership. Very recently, the Department of Science and Technology, Government of India, has entered its 50th year of serving the nation through science and technology. And its Foundation Day was celebrated to acknowledge various science and technology initiatives undertaken by DST over the years. DST's efforts were specially recognized for combating the COVID-19 outbreak by initiating myriad activities in different parts of the country throughout the year. DST and its autonomous institutions have elevated science and technology in India to international levels and reached out to the people across communities. DST, by providing the largest extramural research and developmental support in our country, has been strengthening the national science and technology capacity and capability through a competitive mode to scientists cutting across institutions and disciplines. DST's efforts have helped India attaining third position globally after China and the United States in terms of number of publications in Science Citation Index journals.